I was just talking to myself and I said to myself, of course, I am horrified. I am terrified, I am horrified. And it doesn't matter really how I feel. It's my job, it's my duty to alert people who participated in this Central Intelligence Agency, MI5, this German heist for a greater Lebanon realm, for the sake of more cash, for the sake of more power, for the sake of more. It's my job to alert people from around the world. In this case, I'm going to use Russia as an example. I'm going to use a Tiananmen Square in China, where once revolution took place. Central Intelligence Revolution, to make myself clear. For the worse, when it comes to China. It's hard for me to see these things on the internet. Read basically the news about how they found body here, body there, how some journalist was thrown through the window here, some other one was killed somewhere else, how they found the corpse in a trunk, how they... In this case, we're talking about a Russian journalist, Rybin is his name, Alexander Rybin, and his corpse was found along the edge of the road, they say, and it does have an impact on me because he might not even be dead, you know. He might not be dead. Listen to me. Listen to me very good. The guy might not be dead. He could have filed for death certificate. Yeah. We have seen in Russia Navalny's, we have seen in Russia imaginary opposition, non-existing people. That are the people like you would take a fucking pencil and you make something on a paper, a face, and you would say, go find this one. This is the one who's going to replace me. Basically, talking about Putin, talking about these politicians around the world, not only Putin. Putin is not so much different from the politicians around the world. Prime ministers, ministers. It seems like the only one that stays there somehow, that it's glued to the seat. It appears this is not involved in the politics. It's quite funny. Are actually royals, kings and queens and princes. Oh shit, even princes disappear here and there. You even have some prince here and there washed away by tsunami or something like that. If investigative journalists would go and investigate this stuff, and this stuff is all coordinated with international central intelligence, KGB, and other intelligence community agencies, associations, whatever you want to see this as, you wouldn't find shit on this guy probably. Maybe you would find a real corpse. Usually these days, people get cremated. Vladimir Putin came up with a Putin cremation machine. It's basically a bus that is loaded with a high electricity power or whatever, where you would dispose corpses. And the only thing you would see is a smoke basically coming from the chimney. Off you would go, the corpses disappear in CO2 in the air, basically. Whew. The other day I read the news about how some couple in the US had 160 corpses in storage and did not provide people with their services. It in fact gave them fake cremation dust, whatever. And so we live in a, such a beautiful world that, you know, it's all kinds of news that is out there. Usually when it comes to the Russian war, it's all kinds of stuff that goes on. I'm not going to touch any of it on both sides, whatever. It's like this everywhere. It's like this in the United States. It's like this in Germany. It's basically, it's universally polluted. Disinfo, I would say. It's universal. It's loaded. It's polluted. If you would go and investigate that stuff, it could be eventually that you would be even told that once they would learn basically what your problem is, what your issue is, whatever. If your government would not stop you, whatever. I'm not going to say you could even get yourself killed or whatever. But a lot of journalists, when they investigated this kind of issues, found that victims, even of the political killings, I should say relatives of these victims, maybe even kids, parents, whatever, would indicate that it's not so bad after all. You will exit clueless. And if you would insist, maybe really something even bad could happen or whatever. Practically, investigative journalism no longer exists. It exists only to the certain extent. It's limited. As for limited investigative journalism, I'm going to say, fuck it, it doesn't exist. I'm going to summarize for you. Whatever you would go out there, it's subjected to the politics, it's subjected to political lobby, and as an investigative journalist, if you don't comply, you do fucking die. There's been, I don't know how many journalists killed on the front lines where they would go to investigate in wars, and many of these investigative journalists, what do they have to say about their parents, their relatives, their kids? Nothing really. You get to watch every day, day after day, you get to watch same faces, same people on the internet, same so-called investigative journalists. It is somehow people still that are doing investigative journalism can somewhat say something as long as they stay on a radar with a big companies like CNN, I don't know, BBC, somebody that covers their ass basically enough to even keep alive if they really want to do investigative journalism, and they do have to comply. Everybody has to comply. The point here is that if you are not known, well-known person, and it was way too many of you people around the world that you participated in this super duper it's been circling around this Nigerian scam. So the so-called Nigerian scam Anywhere from email phishing, they're associated with all kinds of issues. Everything out there was associated with Africa, with Asia, Asian carp invasive species, all kinds of invasive species. Except for the Royal Scam, except for the London 1-800 London Cabal, British, German, American made, homemade terrorism, paved through the corruption, through the biggest corruption case ever. They demanded for me to refer to this as highest MK Ultra profile. This isn't fucking MK Ultra profile. This is about not counterintelligence, but this is about creating a turmoil, taking down governments, not because you would not, as a central intelligence agency or as MI5 or as a German Bundestag, agree with them, because you don't really give a fuck about the people. It became evident out of my own case. But simply to cause a turmoil in the country, in whatever country is of your interest, to cause turmoil in one, and through the clusterfuck, through the clusterfuck technology, through the repeated sabotage, to make people sabotage the system through asserting in people the power of the negativism, cause as many clusterfuck retardation problems to existing government options, so that those would just simply start to catch themselves for the middle finger, until eventually it would be revolution that would break out through the economic crisis, etc., etc. Basically, always on the same concept, done not only by United States of America and Germany, but completely coordinated with Russia, indifferent from what I stated, was attempt a coup in a Beijing Tiananmen Square, where and when China managed to somehow raise itself from the gates of hell, from the total exploitation, slavery, from its knees, it somehow managed to push itself upright. They launched absolutely everything they had in stock to cause as many, it's always human rights related issues, as they possibly could. And it's basically, it's different everywhere. The thing about this video is a message to the people that were involved in MKUltra. It's a lot of people that have taken, I'm not going to say the wrong pattern. I don't think anybody who ever sided with me ever have taken the wrong pattern. It's just the people that have seen themselves in me, in a regular person, in a regular human being that was subjected to that torture. Next to this, state officials who oftentimes would take things too seriously at the beginning, gradually, systematically, the state people got to know, unfortunately, most of the time, always, almost always, too late. They would understand, they would grasp about what the fuck is going on, when they would get answers from Americans, Germans, Britons, not so much Germans, but mostly from Americans and from the Britons, on how it's just not a German, this guy with them, but just some guy from some Eastern European country is what basically Americans and Britons substituted Germans who employed me in their service. Basically, the answer to the concerned parties with where is this guy from? Who is this guy? Where is he from? This is just some guy from some Eastern European country. I don't know. He's just from some Eastern European country. It's some guy from Eastern European country. This was the answer. Faces of the Germans, Aryan whites, that would literally use me, basically of Adolf Hitler descendants, basically of descendants of the Nazism creation, basically descendants of those that murder in Congo, say Belgian Congo, or throughout Namibia, throughout the Africa, where they massacred people throughout the Asia, employed them in a chain, and they chained those people, when they exterminated people that would, number of the people that would maybe even equal, I don't know, maybe what is it, maybe was what, quarter of, maybe half of the world, basically, that makes Adolf Hitler like a little baby Hitler when compared to the British Empire, answered concerned parties around the world. This is just some guy from Eastern Europe, because they wanted to develop the concept of the white power. And that concept of the white power is best created by a neo-Nazi posing next to some victim that pursues himself as white in front of the foreign cultures, thus magnifying, amplifying the picture about the non-existing in the heads of the people from other ethnicities, races from around the world. It is all done through the torture, through the bestiality, with the complete assistance and support of the Mother Russia, Mother Russia, Vladimir Putin. And so these people that did not know what the fuck went on, whether black or Asian or South American, whatever, race, ethnicity, systematically learned that something is just isn't fucking right. The faces of this colonizers, descendants of the neo-Nazis, eventually even disappeared from the picture. And they would substitute their faces eventually with Uncle Tom's. With Uncle Tom's from United States of America, or believe it or not, even facial characteristics of some people from Mideast or whatever, the multiculturalism in Britannia, in Germania, would produce enough to simply be used to glorify their owners in comparison with me. This is one thing you need to understand about this case, that this case was the case of It was an attempt to create a coup of the world. It was an attempt to crush, to smash the whole world. It was an attempt to, through the undermining, to the most severe undermining, collapse entire global society so that people, or I should say allies of the yesterday, and people of this world, simply whatever country you might be, no longer would see themselves in a countries where those are. It's a very, very simple concept how the German, Brito-German, American scumbaggery works is on a very, very simple principles. These are very, very simple principles. This fuckatardia in this world of what they created is the world that the human rights, anywhere from United Nations, Amnesty International, and we have a European Court for Human Rights, and we have all this human rights, universal rights, and no fucking rights. World is done in a such a way so that the people that would be allowed to participate were lured in a crime through offering them substantial amounts of money if they would assist me, of which much of it was available because the British royals, because all the royals around the world were my friends, and they wanted to help me at all the costs. And so they were looking for, according to them, they were looking for an allies that would help me, that would assist me find my path out of this hell. Which doesn't matter. They created this hell, and they continue to deteriorate one. Whether you want to become a YouTube star, the algorithm would assist you to get more views, promote you more, therefore you would make more money. Whether you are interested in opening your business, it would be possible to access one literally by using your local government and or international connections for you to get merchandise on time at lower costs, shipping, etc., etc. Whether you wanted to travel to Lula land or you'd like to purchase a cheaper real estate, get a promotion at your work, or even find a job. It was no way of how low this stuff went on. It all depended on a person, his, her qualifications, and the poverty of the country they targeted, basically, to get their things done, you know. And it was extremely successful. It's too much stuff for me to tell here about this stuff. Some of the stuff that angers me, it makes me actually really mad when I think about for the stuff I was used. It's actually even hard on where to start this shit, where to give this tale out, because it's so disgusting. Anyhow, the people they were looking for, the messengers, the helpers that were out there to assist me, there's only one problem with that stuff. It would be very, very difficult to get me to cooperate with. And that's probably because of the torture done on me. But that's the kind of stuff the people that were involved in MKUltra didn't have no control over. And it was the stuff that would eventually offer people the ability to torture me. And then based on torture performed on me, it would, if they have committed themselves to one, for the sake, of course, money, cash, profitable business opportunities, it would, whether you wanted to succeed in Hollywood or get a new song or whatever, or sell more of your products through whatever records, get market. This is basically the way it worked, this stuff. I just regret that many of the people that got involved in it did not profit anything from within. I simply regret that many of the people that got involved in it, because of the state officials, became who witnessed this shit and, in other words, enforced this stuff, together with the Slovenian police, who witnessed this stuff, in other words, enforced this stuff, they would just get themselves a lot of trouble if they started to see myself, and they would start to develop divisions of seeing themselves in me, believing in what they have seen was in front of them and was complaining about, and giving them some kind of picture that was a picture that obviously would promote whatever the British, Germans, Americans have used me for. That's basically to stay clear of the Nazism while in fact promoting a Nazism. These people would get themselves in trouble, they would get themselves jobless. In other words, it would be a new era of a fuckatardia opportunities that would open for the CIA, for the MI5, for other intelligence agencies, Western agencies throughout the world that were eager to recolonize this world, to get one back in a chain, basically, under control. And really, they did this really successfully, employing the people that would start to see problems within the society. I don't know. I am shocked to note the connection between people that I see I have met in the Russia, that met me in the Russia, it's just incredible. Because they're meeting the people throughout the Russia and they're asking them about what do they think about the war in Ukraine, and it really, really breaks me because I see these people, some of which I am actually very, very angry, because they're asking people, they continue to point me out how the Russian people don't have toilets, how they live in wooden homes, and you know, they ask people about how do they feel about life in Russia. Obviously, life in Russia is not a It was tougher than this, probably, I would say, but it's not the best time in Russia right now. I think it's tough. It's not difficult to understand why is it tough, and they are asking people about questions like, why the fuck do you live inside of the home that is, you know, a wooden home, why do Russians still go and use toilets that are outside on the air, that they don't have you know, where you would just store your canalization, basically, right? Canalization, all right. So that would be used to empty that canalization, where it's you know, the rural Russia. Why do you support Putin if you live poorly? You know, I have a problem with it. I am going to tell you frankly that a lot of these people, many of them were idiots. A lot of them did a lot of bad things. But this is not the point, you know. The point here is that most of them did bad things because they didn't know any, they didn't have any sense to do it differently. This is, you know, this is the country that is a dictatorial country. This is, I'm sure you understand, asking the man that you see right there, is like you would go to the neo-Nazi Germany in 1941 or 1942, and you'd be asking about the Hitler, basically. You would say, how the fuck, hello, hi, howdy, howdy, hi. Can you tell me about what you think about Hitler? Do you think the Hitler is doing good? The bombs are falling, okay? So how do you like, you don't get the milk on time in the store, or you don't get food? And what do you think about your going to shit, to take dump outside of your house, and you... you don't have canalization in your house and stuff like this. Yeah, what do you think about that kind of stuff? You know, you don't get to see the war anywhere where this stuff is being pimped at, and Ukraine is doing absolutely everything possible not to get into the Russia and kill civilians like a Russian Hitler does. They don't want to do the same thing. They don't want to do that kind of stuff because they know how long hatred can last for. And they might do it, I don't know. But so far, they have avoided. And I'm not going to give you any comment on it. I already commented. I know that with the people like Putin, you just simply, you don't come to an end. This is the people that you cannot negotiate. He's a terrorist. And with the terrorists, there is only one way to do it. When the nation takes the wrong turn and side with a scumbag like this, then there is only one way to get it done. I already told you about this on my blog, what I think, how I see these things. I don't want to get myself into life in the USA where I spent, well, close to 11 years and a half, more. I don't want to get into that and compare one with the people that eventually do have their houses. They eventually do have a transport. They eventually can go to the physician and use one, contrary to most of Americans, whenever they need, for whatever they deem it can be helped. I don't want to get myself into this kind of discussions. Just because people live in wooden houses and they take dump out of the house in separated toilets like they used to have in the Wild Wild West. Basically, that's how it goes in these rural areas throughout Russia, it appears to me. This is what I see in the videos. That doesn't mean that they are completely dehumanized, that they just don't, their lives are the lives of not worthy of the human being, or it's a worthless life. These people you see here, maybe even every one of them, lives much better than the average American does. They eat goods, just like they explain you. Oh, it's called air toilet. They go to the doctors, physicians, whatever they suffer from, if they have a health problems. Hopefully they have a work, which I think they do. They don't get paid so much as they do in America, but they don't have to live from paycheck to paycheck to meet the bitter end at the end of the month, with many ending under the bridges, homeless, surviving out there inside of the forests, really out on a fucking open. Nowhere near suffering from diabetes and issues that are related to, as World Health Organization states, to the developed world. But this video, this is not what this is all about. It doesn't matter. What this video is about is my basically equaling the people that you see here. Some of them are even gonna probably, I've seen some ladies expressing open protest against Hitler of the modern days on a camera. I would say, I don't understand you as somebody who did real investigative journalism. How the fuck you go to a country like this and you dare to open out there, interrogate people about basically getting themselves rope around their necks? Do you, I'm sure you do, know what is going to happen with every one of these people if they would publicly not side with Vladimir Putin? Putin already have used examples. Every one of these people was involved in MKUltra, folks. These are leads that are enforced by the Central Intelligence Agency. And it successfully so employed these leads in certain elements, in certain people, that for whatever reasons, their lives is hard, difficult, or they might be just honest enough. Honest to the degree that they're willing to commit themselves to death, basically. But in this issue, you know, it used to be the time when what a person thought, expressed its opinion, protested publicly, it actually mattered. It made a difference in this world. But today in this world that I witnessed to, it doesn't make any fucking difference. It only makes difference in those who use me for, I'm not going to say for the espionage only, but to literally create a turmoil in the countries. It is not a straight to the Russia. If I go from the Russia to the Africa, and I was in Ghana just yesterday, I think it was. This Keta Lagoon that they would keep delivering me to Ghana, you know. It was clean. It was, I remember British royals. I remember, you know, Europeans, Americans. They would deliver me here and, you know, it just, what can I say? I was asked. I didn't want to be here. Simple as this. I didn't want to be here. I didn't want to be on a picture anywhere. I didn't want to have nothing to do with MKUltra. And they just, to get into the pants of the African people, started to demand for me to vision myself here, to envision myself here in this country, all of a sudden that it's like, this is your new homeland. That's it. This is your land. This is your home. That's it. And I was like, what the fuck? What are you talking about? Hijacked me eventually. I'm from the United States of America and threw me, dumped me, beginning the 95, also to this place. It was not only to this place. It was Israel, wherever in the globe, whether that be South Africa or Nigeria or Ethiopia, whomever they were trying to jump into the underwear, into the pants, talking about a British MI5 or Germans or American Central Intelligence Agency, they would just come out with some kind of, always after they would do torture. Torture would last for about a week, maybe 2 weeks before they would transfer me abroad. So that I would already come, not very happy, body, whatever in the picture, and then deal with this people from whatever that would just try to do the best impression possible on their visitors, who always was extremely generous. This visitors from America, from the Germany, from the Britannia, they were always so generous, my God. They were so fucking generous that if you would take in whatever country you're from, let's say that I would host them and I would take a dump right at the table. Nice. They would not give absolutely any kind of honest feedback about what had they seen, about what they really thought. It was all about getting in a pants for whatever cost to whomever, also using me next to them eventually to give the feedback that would then set these people from whatever I would be hijacked to basically on toes. And they would start to ask, where the fuck is this guy from? Whatever. Because it was a different opinion, because it was a different view. And then it would be anger from this natives, whatever I would be, whatever country, doesn't matter. It could be China, it could be whatever place. Onwards, you would have the offers raining from the British, from the Germans, from Americans as per. But you know, eventually in our country, we have this and we have that. But how would you feel if it would make this affordable to you? How would you feel if you would make the factory around the corner? Or how would you feel if I make the shop available in your city that would sell such and such shoes or whatever? And this is basically the way this shit went on. Reality mattered no longer. Who gave a fuck about reality? Who cares about reality when we have better than reality? We have offers we're going to give you that you're not going to be capable to refuse. They're going to be generous, profitable for you, for your careers, for your lives, for the people around you. You're going to get the stuff that beyond your dreams. You just have to help this guy. You just have to help this guy. This guy, fucking help this guy. It's the Russians, they are after him. It's the Russians, they are after him. You just got to help this guy because it's Russians that are after him. For whatever other issues, if you don't like, you have the right to torture him. And eventually you will get very financially rewarded for the torture, for your torture, because we appreciate a better, a more just world. Wasn't it like this exactly that it was? Exactly like this? Well, it was exactly. precisely like this. And at my no surprise, I would even get myself people posing next to me, pointing at me as per my being fucking evil. And for the natives to actually even remember their facial features, how different they are from mine, and so on and so forth. Wow. Soon I was demonstrated where the Russia is and where Poland is, and eventually I was welcomed by Americans and Germans to the Belarus, to the Czech Republic, to whatever. I'm not a fan of the Slavic countries, but yeah, Slavic country, given that I'm from Slovenia. On one hand, they demanded practically the support for the Nazism. On the other hand, they condemned the Nazism, depicted themselves as a just people, and have even used the issues of the Nazism as a double razor, as a double sword, basically, as a double sword knife, whatever. If you sit on one as a Ukrainian, it was the Putin that really appreciated. Or if you sit on one as, Dagestani or Kazakhstani or Tajikistani or whomever. You understand? I told you this shit went on with not that it went with the full support of the Russia. Russia needed this. They needed this. This was the ticket. This was the ticket to Ukraine or Baltic states or whatever. On the other hand, for the sake of the political correctness, there was nothing to worry about because I was the one who paid for it all. And I was from some fucking Eastern European country, white, giving the idea to the rest of the world that it wasn't only colonizers and Nazis, descendants of the Nazis to fear from, but it was this whole white picture that was used actually to polarize the world on Asian race, black race, white race, red race, which is almost American natives, either from Northern or Southern America, almost are completely white now. Then I have to say that the biggest tragedy is actually not even seen. It went unacknowledged. And basically, so it goes. So it went for no less than 52 years. For 52 years, 52 years. And it was extremely lucrative, as the colonies of yesterday began to beg over the course of the time to become colonies of today, of tomorrow, basically as fast as possible. You have a number of the countries that are fucking begging to get fucked. They're begging, basically, to get the chain around their neck, my brothers in Africa. Watch this video. Pay attention to it. A number of the countries, I'm going to take a Ghana example here. Ghana, this lagoon, it's called Keta Lagoon, this beautiful place here. This place here, you know, this place here used to be a gorgeous place all the way up to sometimes 1998. After 1998, the British royals no longer would come here because in their eyes, this place eventually turned into a dumpster. It's beautiful the way you see it, but it's nowhere near to what it used to be. In the last 30 years, beginning the 1990, when the population of the Ghana was about 12 million people, something like this, the population skyrocketed into the 32 million people, more than twice it skyrocketed within the last 30 years. With a Ghana people, when I told them it really started to look more and more close to the dumpster than what it used to be. And Ghanaian people, knowing that I am talking about the truth, knowing that that stuff I'm talking about is real, and if things are going to go like this, it's going to turn into a dumpster. After 2000, this was unrecognizable. When the British Royals returned back here, the water, everything was fucking unrecognizable. Goodbye, this beautiful lagoon. The thing about it is that they became so angry, and when Americans and Germans and British told them, fuck him, you know, he's just a racist, whatever, that whatever I would say, and it didn't matter how honest it was and how factual it was, in their heads, eventually it prevailed as something evil. In other words, unrealistic, unreal. As long as we're gonna live in some kind of delusion, in some kind of, how you say this, I'm not gonna say Fata Morgana, but literally delirium, as it was becoming more and more painful. As it was becoming more and more and more the more it was becoming painfully fucking evident, the more painful it was becoming, it no longer was like unrealistic or declining to see what eventually the pictures, but it started to go fucking through the painful, real. It started to grow into fucking delirium. Well, my friends, this is the same kind of syndrome health, mentally related issue as to the one the Russians are suffering from. You have seen here a number of people, some of which Kaya White also crazy, that claim how wonderful it is in Russia, when actually it's really not wonderful. And they're going to claim it's wonderful, it's wunderbar, for the cost of the fucking bombs flying all over their homes, whatever the fuck might be, streets, turning the fucking streets into the fucking dust. It still doesn't matter. It's wonderful. It's fucking wonderful. This is exactly the type of concept that Vladimir Putin have used together with the Central Intelligence Agency, with the Germans, with the British MI5, when they were guiding me on a dog leash through the streets of Moscow and all other cities throughout Russia. Never fucking mind Moscow and Petersburg and whatever city might be out there. All the cities were on the picture. I had a feeling the fucking villages, every fucking village in Russia got to know me. Every fucking place throughout Russia, through where it bordered with Korea and to the most western part where Finland, Poland meet with Russia, everything in between, in Kazakhstan, along the Kazakhstan and everywhere, and in Kazakhstan and everywhere, whatever. The KGB needed me. They, like dog on the leash, with assistance of Americans and British, they were using them for the espionage to do the stuff, to do the dirty stuff, basically. And so it's this kind of, I'm not going to say mental issue, I'm going to relate to this as a mental illness, but it's this kind of vision, it's this kind of distorted picture, basically, that is deteriorating the world more and more and more and more. Vladimir Putin was a major supporter of in African people, just as Americans did for Vladimir Putin in Russia and Germans and British. They would deliver me over there with their so-called journalists, and you know, it would be meeting people and what do you think way ahead of the war, you know. How do you see this and so on? And it was all kinds of other conversations that would develop on the side, basically, including those of coming war in Ukraine, decades ahead of the war in Ukraine, is what I'm trying to say. It's exactly what Vladimir Putin was employing for the sake of American, British, and German imperialism throughout the Africa, where you know, so in Moscow, Vladimir Putin would teach people from Africa and from Asia and from other parts of the world, basically, to basically, whatever the I say, whatever the fuck this guy say, this is the Western way, this is the way they want, and of course it's not true, of course it's not true this, and of course it's not true that. And he would go and basically rationalize them, proving me wrong, me being dropped up, of course, proving me wrong, basically by standing up in front of these people from Africa and South America and Asia with his military might, basically demonstrating his new tanks, new his weaponry, showing basically the progress and development and strength of the Russia, basically growing, basically on a global scale, becoming a big monstrum, basically getting bigger and bigger. And so these poor people that would come from Africa, Asia, and South America would start to eventually see themselves in a completely imbecilic mentality. The fucking mentality, as I said, if for the cause of the bombs they would start to roar and fly all over this village, it would be still people that would say, oh, it's wonderful, it's fucking nice, man. It's not a problem, everything is good. Let me go back here to the Geta Lagoon. It's not only the Geta Lagoon, it was entire Africa that started to turn itself, knowing basically that it's not okay. It's not right that nature is being destroyed, that natural resources are being overly exploited by simply setting aside what became actually ecological emergencies, real problems. In fact, they should work on, and they have substituted this agony. Now we're talking about the agony. We're talking about the agony. We're talking about delirium. With ever increasing population boost bloom, wherever China declined, stopped, began to enforce control, no fucking food, with no fucking work policy. And that no work policy didn't have to do with whether you're going to go and apply for the job, but it had to do with the birth control. It had to do with ability, basically, for the country to get enough of the foreign market, whatever technology, to fit whatever existed out there. And if necessary, even to decrease the population so that it would meet the quota that it needed to actually to sustain the country, to sustain the economy, to go on forward with it. Africa did exactly the opposite. And other poor countries that you see around the world also did exactly opposite. But what it happened instead of that, it was this corruption case that it bloomed and it fucking exploded. The black man basically setting aside real emergencies and started to search for blame in a government which truly learned basically to govern, to do it basically the Russian way without having the same capacity as to which applied to the Russians. Russians had enormous amounts of oil, petroleum, gas, and that through the trade with the West obtained the new technologies and new stuff, something that Vladimir Putin didn't tell you about. He raised about the Russian science, the Russian ability, because he had to do that, of course. But there was some other picture in between that went on that governments did not pay attention to, and the ever-increasing sentiment of anger, frustration, based on frustration, based on how things went completely different than what they were the day, well, I'm not going to say the day earlier, but, you know, there was more and more revolts, more and more turmoil that started to boil itself. Even in the countries that were quite wealthy, countries such as Libya, let's say, the war exploded throughout the Syria. The wars exploded throughout the Middle East with people acting, leadership basically acting completely idiotic, like it was the case with Saddam Hussein, with some of the leaders completely losing their mind, basically behaving in exactly the same fashion as to the Vladimir Putin did in Russia. Basically, the West used Russia to literally incite many leadership, many countries into leaders, basically into insanely impossible behavior that did not even, you know, people that just started to see themselves basically in a Rolex, in a Rolls Royce, in a military might, how many nukes even I have, how many soldiers I have, how many planes, and what the fuck I can do, look at me. Now they started to grab, like, became like attention grabbing leaders that faced the oppositions that were not interested in enforcing, let's say, a China policy, which was the policy of the stability for whatever cost, but they became a power grabbing. Now, the China policy was based on a communism, on a communist party, which mercilessly enforced its principle for the sake of equality throughout the China. That did not apply to this unruly leaders from around the world that were just doing stupid stuff, and or many politicians that would do all kinds of stuff just to remain on the power and basically be seen. And you know, a corruption just started to turn ministers, prime ministers, politicians into a money-grabbing machines, rather in the game for themselves. This is what the corruption does, this is how it all works, then for the benefit of the society. And so we have more and more wars, and we have more and more poverty raging and raging throughout the world. It is really sad. You know, I'm not using this lagoon here basically to, I'm just using it as an example, an MKUltra example. I'm also giving you advanced knowledge, right? I wouldn't know about any of this stuff if I wasn't there, if I wasn't traveled. And in 1998, this lagoon turned the colors of the water completely different from what they used to be. Already earlier, like in 97 and 96, it was already a pollution that was detected. But in 98, this became completely unrecognizable. In 2000, forget about it. It almost looked already like Biscayne Bay or something like this from Miami. I'm going to put it this way, all right? The countries are urged to take their initiative and view the world realistically, begun to even view themselves basically assuming the responsibility for the poverty and enforcing a China policy, began to see themselves in a concept such as, you know, it's going to be Putin that's going to solve. You know, it's a West, it's America that is doing all this. It's a Germany that's doing, it's British that are doing all this. You know, the unhappiness, you know, the unsatisfaction around the world. You know, the resentment on previous colonization. It always will be present, but to the what fucking extent you lose your fucking mind and start to see yourself in somebody like Vladimir Putin, it really, really does, you know, good, because the leaders in Africa who started to see themselves in a Putin, in a Wagner, you know, let me demonstrate you. Let me demonstrate you what the Wagner is. Now, I'm going to show you what Wagner is. A Russian Wagner. This is a Russian Wagner. This is what Putin is. This here, look. I want you to see this real good. You see, I wish that you could see him barking, basically, straight in the camera. That's what I would like to accomplish, you know. This is Wagner, basically. This here, this is basically the way I see Wagner. You know, you start to enforce something. Rather than to work with the people for the common goal, for the common good, and basically stability of the country, you start to enforce Putin. You no longer see yourself, in other words, in you. There is a whole bunch of these politicians from Africa. I will not go and name the politicians in Africa. You know who the fuck you are. You know who the fuck you are. And you also know, you know this, that once you're going to start to see yourself in a Putin, you know very good you're going to lose your fucking country. Many of you fuckers know that once you're going to start to see yourself in a Vladimir Putin, you are going to be choosing between the colonization, which is going to be done by the West, or you're going to go under the West, or you're going to go under the Russia. You know, once you start to see yourself in Putin, you know that the rest of your brothers and sisters in Africa are going to be compelled to choose between the Putin and between the West. You know this, right? You fucking know this thing. Every one of you fuckers know these things. Whoever promote that beast in Africa knows what I stated here. You know it. You know these things, that once you're going to start to see yourself in a Putin, you're going to lose your national identity. Not that you're going to lose your national identity, but you are out there for this barking here that you see. You know that you're doing this. You know that when you do something like this, you know it's going to bring the other part of the world. That's why Germany and Britain and all these countries don't give a fuck about how you see yourself. They'll help you. Once you're going to start to see yourself in Putin, they're going to give you even the reason, basically, for you to see yourself in Putin. That's what I'm saying, that once you're going to start to see yourself in Putin, you can wave goodbye to your independence, to your sovereignty. We have another phenomena here. It's called the childish Gambino, and it's really kind of stupid. It will make me feel, because not only because I was on the spot, they would use me for the spot, they had me participate in the spot, and they even promised me that they would help me out and so on. But the thing is, you know, fuck this. I don't see myself in this spot. Yeah, it really is. Taking basically, doing bad stuff, taking money basically. Take the money, do bad stuff and take the money. I completely agree with it. You know, I completely agree with it up to here. When it's this chwar here, you know, when it's this chwar here, I agree. I agree with the stuff. You know, they told me, the man you see right there that's doing this spot, he told me that they were nice to me, these people from the church, the black people, that there was churches, black churches that were involved in this stuff. The thing is, they were not nice to me. They were not nice to me. They did a lot of bad stuff. They did the stuff that when it comes to the country that was funded on a slavery and as descendants of the slaves should never do to anybody. In other words, they haven't seen themselves in themselves. They have seen themselves, truly they have seen themselves in the money. And what this portion of the video spot, at least for me, implies to what I earlier stated to you, if you will help this guy, you know, if you will help this guy to redeem himself for what he does and what the fuck I was doing, what I was doing, who, what is the person that is dropped up, tortured, what kind of control does the person have? So it basically has none, really. So that you're going to present witnessing for me and for that matter, you're going to be awarded for it, is what Germans, British, Americans advertised. It's not the case. This isn't the case. I'm not the one who wants these people killed, hurt, despite them doing the stuff they shouldn't have done it. I'm not the one who is doing it. I'm not the one who was doing this stuff. I'm not the one who... You understand me what I'm saying? Earlier I have talked to you about the double razor, double sword, double-edged sword. But I'm not the one that enforced this stuff. You're not helping me for me to cause the damage, for me to hurt you. You got it all wrong. That's what I'm trying to say, because it's like, it makes me feel like for doing something good to me, you get to be shot. Basically, this is the way from my end, this is the way I interpreted that stuff. You know, sorry, I don't see you that way. I see you collectively. I don't see you separately. When it comes to the certain issues, I see you. Pay attention when I said to the certain issues. I thought about this stuff a lot, enormously a lot. I knew every millimeter of whatever people who designed this crime, how they enforce this crime, why, and so on. Certain issues apply to you people of United States of America from all sorts of, from all your variety of racial backgrounds and ethnicities on the same level. This is the place to your constitution, to your bill of rights, etc., etc. It goes the same to others that pertain, that participated in the United Nations. To a lot of other nations, it goes the same shit to you. Or wherever you maintain multiracial societies, such as Britain and Germany now, etc., etc. It goes equally to you. All through, I am American citizen. I got my citizenship in 2000 in the U.S. I am also, I should say, American citizen. And that obligates me more to talk about America than, let's say, France or Britain or Germany or whatever. I'm not the one who is going out there to hurt you for your ignoring your past based on which you continue to claim injustice is taking place against you. No, you got it all fucking wrong. You got it all wrong. You got to pay attention to this video, what this video is all about. I'm about completely other issues. I don't want to see myself in whatever the British in a drawer they want to stash me in and keep me in. You're not going to get me into that drawer. I'm outside of that drawer. I see the picture from a different perspective. I see it from a global perspective and where this picture have taken us on a long term. And also, as I explained to you, where this picture is going to take us next. Because, you know, once you're going to start to see the solution in a white man, once you're going to start to call the white man that's going to come, and you learned a lot to call white men to come and solve your problems. Because when the problems ran out of your hand, and you know, you lose completely control over your problems. One of the biggest problems is the population, uncontrolled population, birth, and so on. You're gonna need more and more and more assistance. And, you know, there is people barely waiting to come to rescue. In fact, once you're gonna start to see yourself in a Wagner, once you're going to start to see yourself in a barking dogs, in the dogs that do killing in Ukraine, to the people to whom Vladimir Putin claims have the same DNA as the Russians. Do you know that Vladimir Putin claims that the Ukrainian people have the same DNA as the Russians? Once you're going to fucking start to see yourself in shit like this, it won't even fucking matter whether you want Putin anymore in the picture or not. Don't you understand how the Putin got on your picture? In Africa, I'm talking about United States of America, Britain, Germany, and so on. They will make sure that you will get Putin on a picture, whether you fucking like it or not. That you're going to start to see yourself more and more and more in Putin till you fucking disappear from the picture, like the people in Syria did. You know, Syria? This is fucking Syria.
Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Look how I'm living now. Police be tripping now. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. We gon' blow like, yeah. America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look
look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up. I'm so fitted. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get it. Watch me move. This is Sally. That's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak.
Black.
Ooh, know that.
Yeah.
Ooh, get it. Yeah.
Get it.
Yeah. Work it.
Yeah. 100 bands, 100 bands, 100 bands. Contraband. I got the plug on who a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like Waka Blah.
Listen, whatever the hell you are, you don't have anywhere near as much power as they have. You don't have anywhere near edge they have over you. And you are the one that depends on this international laws and treaties eventually that were built to protect you. Whether you like it or not, and it might be painful for you, it could be that tomorrow that's going to come is going to be far more painful and it's going to be indifferent from the 100 years ago. Your predecessors, ancestors have suffered from. That's all I want to do for this video. I'm gonna tell you also something else, that whatever you are, try to work with your government. If I ever really make it big, I am only going to work with the people that are interested in a long-term stability from whatever country you're from. Making sure that the people who participated in MKUltra, left and right and in the middle, are somehow protected. That those who understand this video, rather than see themselves possibly even in some kind of things that should absolutely have nothing to do with it, I'm not distancing myself from them because I had absolutely nothing to do with it. And work together with one another for the more stable tomorrow. Because, you know, asking people about how they feel about Putin, asking people about after pissing off people that started to see themselves in many cases completely unrealistic about it just doesn't answer. I can do this. I can go out there and, you know, but just know that every one of these people that gives their interview, I don't like the idea about people getting fucked. That I don't believe in this kind of journalism at all. This is no fucking journalism. Basically exposing people to it's not good. It's not good under this kind of circumstances to go out there, and the people that were involved already suffered a lot. How about if I go and ask you journalists, the so-called journalists, that you were doing nothing other than espionage for the CIA, which went overboard and literally went into the area of creating a turmoil, a revolution in the country. What about stuff fucking asking you? How are you making sure that these people that give you opinion? I heard about even some interviewers staying on their interviews, that it's the opinion of certain individual that actually is worthy to be seen on the internet, how about I start to fucking ask you guys a question? Like, how are you making sure that these people that give you a feedback, on honest feedback on how they feel in the country, how about start asking you, what steps have you taken to make sure that these people are not gonna get persecuted tomorrow? There is, as I earlier pointed out, list of journalists. Some were not killed, some disappeared, some whatever, wherever they did, some were killed. It's difficult to know which one what under this kind of circumstances. But if I ask you, and it would be the most honest question, don't go and ask. Some of them are spies, some of them are Putin spies, you know. If I go out there and they pretend they're opposition and they're not, how about if I go and ask you, journalists, and ask you, what steps have you taken, rather than you saying that it was opinion somebody is actually was worthy to lend, put one on the internet? How about I go ask you guys, you give me honest, tell me, what steps have you taken or you would take from the West to protect people that give you the public opinion? Would you open them jobs? Would you make sure that they receive that social support or that they have a place to live tomorrow? Are you gonna make them immigration to the West accessible? And how, once if they immigrate to the West, how are you gonna make sure that this they will stay alive, they will be safe? You know, these people have families and so on and so forth under this kind of circumstances, and especially because of what I stated this case was used for, I completely distanced myself from it. And I'm warning people around the world to be cautious about it, to distance yourself from, you know, from this brainwash, you know, give an honest opinion, you know, give an honest, you know, what you think. And this and that, if you participated, try to control your anger, try to control your emotions, and think rationally, think on a broader scale where this picture is going to take us collectively, basically where this stuff is taking us to. That's all I want to say for this video. I am extremely disappointed with the Germans, with the British, with Americans, obviously. The most honest evaluation I ever got about truly what went on was given to me by the British royals, who eventually stated me that they would use Slovenian police, they would use Slovenian police causing more and more mayhem, more and more crime. Reminder, my 92 years old father is at home for elderly people. It's a question how he's gonna drive through if it will be subjected to this psychiatric Slovenian police malpractice for the last 25 years. They delivered him in home for elderly people. Well, eventually, what started with a voluntarily submitting himself to torture grow literally into the real strokes, play with the strokes issues. Admitted they would use police because of the harm, because of the damage, because of the ruined reputation they have done to me. They have no face anymore to get on a picture and resolve the crime as the crimes are resolved. I find this more than anything because of degree of crime that was enforced against me. To what degree this shit went is incredible. It is cynical. I find this as cynical, not as anything other than amplification of crime against me. I don't see this as an admission or anything like this. But can you imagine somebody tells you that because your reputation around the world, your public image has been so much ruined, destroyed, damaged through the MKUltra bestiality, that they would be using a police basically to negotiate the genocide, the extermination against me, which they committed, which swallowed no less than 52 years of my life. Now, I don't have anything else I would say for this video. It is disgusting. To note that I was in a ring of people, and it should come to you as a warning wherever you are. I was in the ring of the people that had absolutely no human conscience. The only conscience is a conscience that it breaks down. It breaks down as far as what you have seen have taken place on my blog. They don't care about you, whether you're in Russia or you're in China or you're in South Africa or you are in Africa or you are in Brazil or you are in Mexico or wherever the fuck you are. They don't care about you. They care about, just like in my case, first when they came inside of this house, they were foreigners. They had to make themselves comfortable through portraying themselves as somebody in home environment is here to rather help. Till it became clear to my family that for involvement in crime, there are rewards also. And went ahead for the whole cake, basically, to take over absolutely everything. Ruining me even health. They don't care about you. They don't care about anybody. They care about how to get into your country and rob you of absolutely everything. Human soul, not only your job, your employment, your work. Forget about health.